In this video, we'll learn about prohibitions and licenses with a specific focus on what they are and their advantages and disadvantages. While you are watching this video, comment below or in your own notes about some of the prohibitions and licenses in your country and what their impact has been for better and for worse. Prohibitions are laws that ban the sale or production of a good or service. They can also be used to make certain practices illegal, such as employing children. Common examples of prohibitions around the world include alcohol, drugs, and prostitution. Governments have a variety of reasons for prohibiting these things, and we'll look at the case for and against prohibitions next. On the surface, prohibitions seem like an effective solution to eliminating a problem. If it is successful, there is likely to be an improvement in social welfare. As a problem is reduced, there is also less money spent on policing the activity. In the example of alcohol consumption, there's very likely going to be a reduction in antisocial behavior. These are all great reasons to use prohibitions, but unfortunately, the reality can be quite different, hence the disadvantages of this approach. Once you make something illegal, you drive it underground and into the black market. There are many countries in the world where drugs and alcohol are forbidden, but people can still access them. If you are watching this video in a country where something is prohibited, comment below on whether or not the illegality has completely eliminated access to such things. The ownership of such industries is removed from legitimate businesses. Second, once something is prohibited and not traded legally, there is a loss of tax revenue from its sale. You may still have social problems and actually face rising police costs, as a black market is hard to control. If people are buying products on the black market, there are no more quality assurances that come from the government on such products. Some argue that the legalization of marijuana in the US has led to the improved quality of the drug available in some states. In countries where alcohol is prohibited, some homemade versions have potentially dangerous side effects. Government oversight and control of production would help address these issues. Finally, a prohibition infringes on consumer sovereignty. The consumer loses the right to choose what to consume, and instead, this decision is made by the government. A license is a legally required document that permits a firm or individual to conduct a certain activity. The one most people are familiar with is a driving license, which permits you to operate a certain type of automobile. Businesses may need licenses for a variety of reasons, including building, selling certain types of products, or conducting specific activities. Individuals may require a license for working in a specific field, such as teaching or medicine. Additionally, they may also need licenses for such things as driving or owning pets. As before, there are advantages and disadvantages of licensure. The first advantage would be improved standards. With government oversight, they can ensure that the person or business in need of the license meets sufficient requirements to carry out such activities. You would most likely visit a doctor with a medical license over one who does not have one. Licenses can also help provide consumers with higher qualities of products or services. If you are visiting a restaurant that is licensed to serve food, it will have to meet certain health and safety standards to be permitted to serve you. If you are getting a haircut from a licensed professional, you may be more likely to get a better haircut. However, much like prohibitions, licenses are not a perfect solution. The requirement of licenses increases business costs and legal compliance costs. These could mean higher prices to consumers. With regards to occupational licensing, this could limit the number of people entering a profession such as teaching. The requirements necessary to join a certain field may be high enough to restrict access to a privileged group. This shortage of supply in the labor market could lead to higher wage rates and consequently higher prices for consumers. All in all, licenses can be effective at improving consumer welfare, but it can sometimes come at a cost. It is important to be aware of this as you consider the merits of government intervention. That wraps up this video on prohibitions and licenses. You should be more comfortable about the advantages and disadvantages of each. If not, email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com or leave a comment below.